Okay, let's talk about class B subnetting. When I give you a class B subnetting problems, typically followings are given: IP address and subnet mask. And there are two cases for you to consider. The case number one is when the custom subnet mask, when the subnet mask is /20/17 all the way to /24. And case number two is when the custom mask is /25 all the way to 30. And so we're going to use the same notation, just like a class C. X means number of bits used in the subnet portions, and Y means number of bits used in the host portion. So in the class C subnetting, X plus Y is 8, and for the class B subnetting, X plus Y is 16. Okay? So that's the 2 to the X means number of subnet, and 2 to the Y minus 2 is number of usable host addresses for each subnet. And for the reason that you need to subtract minus 2 from this number is that what? Because one is, since one, the one address has to be used for the network address of a subnet, and another one is need to be used for the broadcast address. So you have to subtract minus 2. So let's look at the case one. So this is a case one. So when I give you the subnet mask, if that subnet mask is one of these, then it's a case number one. Okay, and then case number two, when I give you a subnet mask, if that subnet mask is one of these, then it's a case number two. Okay? So let's just first talk about case number one. Okay? So for example, let's take a look at this subnet mask. 128.0, right? 255, 255, 128.0. So, for example, okay, so okay, so one, two, so if the subnet mask is this is case number one, right? First, this is case number one because let's see. 225, sorry, 255 dot 255 dot the first one is what? 128.0, right? That's a subnet mask. And this one is what? We have 1111111111111. 1111, right? This is 255, 255 dot. So 128 is 1000000 dot, and this is 0, right? Okay. So first, so this is /17 because this is 8, and this is 8, and here's a 1. Right, so 8 plus 1 is 17. So this is /17. And what about the X and Y? Okay, first, you know this IP address is hierarchical because let's say this is your IP address, right? Then IP address is a network portions. And then it has subnet portions, right? Subnet portions, and then it has host portions. So the subnet portions, we use notation x. And for the host portion, we use notation y. Right? So in this case, since this is class B, the first 16 bit is always network portions, the class B. And then the subnet portions, in case of slash 17, this is the subnet portions. So this is X. And then remaining bits, that's what? This is for the host portions. So this is Y. So in this case, X is a 1 because 1 bit is used, and then Y is what? 8 plus 7, right? So 15. So obviously X plus Y is 16. Right? This is like first case. And let's look at the next subnet. This one. Okay? So 192, right? So the next one is 255.255.192.0. So that means 1111111.. So this is like 250.255, right? And then 192 is 11000. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, right? In this case, since it's a class B subnetting, so this is your network quotients, and then this one. So you know the subnet mask. The definition of subnet mask is what? Consecutive ones followed by consecutive zero. But anyway, so. And then for the class B subnetting, this is going to be your, so always a network portion is always a 16 bits for the class B subnetting. And for the subnet mask, so this is subnet mask portion, so X is equal to 2 in this case because 2 bits are used. And then Y is 14, the host portions is 14. So obviously X plus Y is 16. Okay, so for first case, the number of subnets, okay, the number of subnet meaning, okay, so let's just first finish this, and then the last example is, case number one, the last case. I'm gonna skip this. And then the last one is this one, right? 255. Oops. Okay, so last one is, so I'll just skip this. And then the last one is 255.255.255.0, right? So that means 1111111.1234.1234.0000, right? So since this is class B subnetting, the network portion is always 16 bits, so 16 bits used. And then your subnet portion X is 8, and then this is what? Y is equal to 8. So this is your host portion, okay? So from this, we can find out number of subnets for each case, and then number of usable host addresses for each subnet. So for this case, right? So for example, like for example, let's say you have. So this is what? This is your IP block, right? And then you will have subnets. right? And the subnet with the equal size. So this is subnet number 1, this is subnet number 2, and etc. And then the first address of each block, right? The first address of each block is subnet address, or the network address of subnet number 1. And this one is what? Network address of the subnet number 2. So basically these are the subnet addresses, the first address of each block. And the broadcast address is the last address of each block. So this is broadcast address. So I'll use a different color. So this is like broadcast address. It's the last address of each block. So number of, so for example, to find the number of subnets, okay, so number of subnets, the formula is 2 to the x, right? And then, so find the number of subnets, that's a 2 to the x, and then find the number of usable host IP addresses, usable host IP addresses is always what? 2 to the y minus 2, right? Because 1 being for the network address or the subnet address, and another for what? Broadcast address. So you need to subtract minus 2 from this value. Okay? So in the first case, right? 2 to the x is what? So 2 to the x is 2 to the 1, which is 2. So in this case, there's only 2 subnets. And then number of usable host IP addresses for each subnet is 2 to the 16 minus 2. It's a huge number. Okay? And this for this case, number of subnets are 2 to the x, right? So 2 to the 2, 4. So in this case, there are 4 subnets. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Subnet number 1, subnet number 2, 3, 4. Okay? In the first case, there's only what? 2 subnets. And the number of usable host IP addresses per each subnet is 2 to the y minus 2, so 14, right? The 2 to the 14 minus 2, which is a pretty big number, but not as big as this. And then the third case, the last case is, x is 8, right? The number of subnet is 2 to the x, so 2 to the 8. So this many are subnets. And then number of usable host IP addresses for each subnet is 8, right? So 2 to the y minus 2, which is 2 to the 8 minus 2. Okay? So that's the number of usable host IP addresses for each subnet. Okay? Now, So to find the valid subnet IP addresses, so meaning to find the valid subnet IP address means network address of the each subnet, right? Network address of the each subnet. To find the valid subnet addresses, the network IP address of each subnet, you have to use the following formula. To find the third octet in each subnet address is equal to multiple of 256 minus third octet of the subnet mask. So this is like a formula. And then the fourth octet value in each subnet is simply 0. Okay. So that's something that you have to remember for the case number 1. to find the valid subnet addresses. So here is like, I'm going to explain this concept using two example. So there's two examples, right? Case one, example one, and example number two. I'm going to just first talk about example number one in the next lecture.